I'm Pastor George Borghardt, and this is another Higher Things video short. A reason for chanting that will make even chant hater love chanting. That's the subject of today's Higher Things video short. Like, subscribe, ring the bell, get the app, donate. If you love our videos, like our videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel, ring the bell for notifications. Did you hear that? Get the app on iTunes, Google Store, and Amazon, and donate. Your tax-deductible gift keeps Higher Things, a youth organization all about passing the faith to the next generation. Keeps us rolling. And we need your gifts in these dark times. So, chanting. Some people love it in the Lutheran church. Some people don't. Amen, joy's got nuts. Mounds don't. There's no arguing that it's Lutheran, since Luther wrote most of the chants that we use in the Lutheran church. But why? Why do we chant? And we've done a lot of videos on this in the description. But more than that, here's why. I'm going to tell you a story. So one of the families at Immanuel goes to a different church. They go to a Baptist church on a Sunday. I don't know if they were going there for something, someone, some friend of theirs or the like, but they were church cheating. But that's not the here or the there here. So they bring their kids, and these are pretty regular attenders at Immanuel. And so during the service in this small little Baptist church in the country, it was the one Sunday that they were going to do the Lord's Supper in church. And so the family sat there and listened to the words of institution as said by this Baptist preacher. And a child, a young child, looks at her mom and says in a child-volumed voice, "That's wrong. That's not how the words go." And the preacher stops, to the horror of the parents, and looks at her and looks at the little girl and says, "Well, little girl, what do you mean? How do the words go?" And she says, "Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night in which he was betrayed, took bread." And she begins to go through the words of institution as she is heard in church chanted. The preacher listening to her, and this is a true story, the preacher listening to her says, "Wow, where did you learn that?" "Well, I learned it in church every Sunday." And he said, "Well, that's very good." And he tries to resume the service. And then, to the horror of the parents again, the child looks at him and says, "And you had the end wrong. It's not, this symbolizes, do this as a symbol of Jesus. It's, Jesus says, do this, this is my body, do this in remembrance of me." That's what Jesus said. Now, first, never church cheat. Your kids will sell you out. But second, you got a little sneeze, buddy? Got a little sneeze? Second, the important thing to remember here is, how did she learn it? She learned it from hearing. One of the reasons why we chant in the Lutheran church is so that children would learn the words. So that we would learn the words. It slows us down. It keeps us from whispering sweet nothings to the elements, as was done in the Middle Ages church. But most of all, it helps children, it helps all of us to learn the words of institution, to learn the scripture. And I've had confirmants do this before too, when they're being examined in front of the congregation, when they have to say the words of institution, "Can we chant it?" Well, of course you can. I, as a pastor, and many pastors can testify to this, when I chant the verba, when I chant the words of institution, I can see in the congregation little children singing with me. Why is this a big deal? One, because we want our kids to be raised in the faith. Two, because when we get older, and we all will get older, and we find ourselves in the old folks' home, and the things aren't all cooking with gas, and we may be a few fries short of a Happy Meal, or 10 gallons of crazy in a 5-gallon bucket. Those words, which were sung in for us all our lives, will remain with us and stay with us. I had this when I was visiting someone who had dementia when I was a young pastor. I sat before them, and they could not understand what was going on. They were worried about the nurses stealing their stuff. They were upset and rattled. And then I began to do the liturgy with them of communion, and they were focused and they were attentive. And I even stopped at one point when I started the Lord's Prayer and said, Auf Deutsch. And I was like, whoa, you're going to have to lead. And they did. Chanting. We chant for the children. We chant to pass on the faith to the next generation. That's why we do what we do. Isn't because it's beautiful. It isn't because it's Roman Catholic. It's not. It's so that the faith would be passed on to the next generation. And that is a reason for chanting that even haters gonna hate, 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 might find helpful. I'm Pastor George Borghardt and Thor, and this has been another Higher Things video short.